So my name is Slava Tikhonov, and I'm senior information scientist from DANZ, and I'm going to tell you something about control vocabulary support in Dataverse data repository. So probably you know that Dataverse is a product that developed by Harvard University, and our task as a shock VP 5.2 is development of different features, and one of those features is external control vocabulary support. So first of all, there is of course a relation between FAIR and Dataverse, and Dataverse team did self-assessment in the end of last year, and basically they discovered that Dataverse scores really high on findable, accessible, and reusable principles, but unfortunately for interoperability there are some weaknesses. And I will show you in next slides what actually is weak in Dataverse. And however, they see FAIR as a kind of process, so there is no possibility to get FAIR compliance, because FAIR can change anytime, and new proposals are coming, and basically it's a dynamic process. So if you are interested in this work, there is a link, and Mercedes Crosas, Chief Data Officer at Harvard University, she did really nice presentation about that. So this is out-of-the-box control vocabulary support in Dataverse. There is a spreadsheet that available in Google Drive, and basically you can change, you can add new values, and you can describe what kind of type of field it will be, and after you should download this file as TSV, upload in Dataverse, and you will get updated metadata list in Dataverse. So this is how it looks like, and obviously it has a few limitations. First limitation, because it's just internal process, so you have to do something with Dataverse, so you have to upload it inside, and there is no possibility to support external control vocabulary support, external control vocabularies. And another thing, because it was developed in the United States, so it was designed without understanding that probably someone else will use other languages. And that's something we are going to fix in our work. So first of all, before I will start to introduce our implementation, there are a few things about interoperability in EOSC. So we are talking about technical interoperability. We want actually all systems to speak the same language. We're talking about semantic interoperability. We want to get your eyes for all concepts, and we're going to use cost for that, like most of people here. Also, there is organizational and legal interoperability. So our work in our task mostly related to two technical and semantic interoperabilities. And in next slides, I will show what we did. So in Dataverse network, we already have a lot of data sets. I think more than 100,000 if you calculate all Dataverse instances running around the world. And how actually to get to provide depositor convenient web interface, and to have possibility to link their metadata to external control vocabularies. This is our question. And if we'll start basically from the beginning, first idea just to get a list of affiliations standardized. And here you can see Global Research Identifier Database, GRID, that was converted in SCoS. And first idea just to have all affiliations linked to this database. And another idea, can we use those links actually to predict what can be linked automatically, and and how to disambiguate concepts with usage of artificial intelligence tools. So I already told you about language limitation and SCoSMOS, and this is very nice framework that was developed by Finnish National Library, and it has, for example, medical subject headings, MASH, that maintained by National Health Institutes from the United States. But what they did, they added two other languages. So all most of concepts available in Finnish and Swedish. So basically, it's different from what from Americans already have. And we have to make it happen. We have to link those entities in Dataverse as well. So SCoSMOS specification is very clear, and because it's a well-established product with long history, we had a lot of discussions how to actually connect Dataverse to SCoSMOS and other technical solutions. And after discussion, we decided, okay, let's try to have Cosmos API specification as a basis for other things as a baseline. And now there is discussion how CV service that will be maintained by CESDA will implement exactly the same protocol. And also we created semantic gateway that I will introduce in further slides. Also, it will get exactly the same protocol, and probably for NDE, because now there is discussion how this network will be connected to Dataverse. So probably it will get exactly the same protocol. So we just need to standardize input and output to have possibility to connect to different technical solutions, providing control vocabularies. Okay. So. It's still in development, but there is already a prototype, and it's called Semantic Gateway, and it's an external application that can connect to Dataverse. And in this application, you can actually define which fields can be linked to which ontologies. So in this specific case, from CMDI metadata, there is an organization that can be connected, let's say, to CESDA mesh or other ontologies, or GRID, of course. And after you will fill Dataverse URL and will choose API token, it will just update configuration inside of Dataverse, and it will be available in the list of control vocabularies. And it's very easy to connect another control vocabularies to extend this semantic gateway, these new control vocabularies. There is basically XML file, and you can specify API endpoint and recipe, how it should be connected. So basically, if it's RESTful API, you just need to add four lines, and it will be automatically connected. It knows how to communicate to Dataverse, because protocol is standardized on input and output. And this is result, how it looks like. So after maintainer will choose control vocabularies for specific fields, it will be available in a list in vocabulary field, and if you'll search on some keyword, it will just go to semantic web gateway. It will query as Cosmos or another system, and it will get a list of concepts, and this list of concepts will be converted to what Dataverse can understand, and it will appear in web interface. So here you can see example how it looks like, and there is like UNESCO and Thesaurus and AgroWork and other ontologies, and basically the same field keyword connected to different ontologies. And the most important thing that in Dataverse you can change language, and if you'll change language, for example, from English to German or French, you will get list of suggested keywords in selected language. But still, it will be, of course, linked to the same URI, which is essential for linked open data. So the way how we implemented this is very similar to what Cosmos has. There is a GET request, and there is filter functionality. So you can just specify language, vocabulary name, and query, and you will get list of suggested terms. So the idea of having this gateway, if you have just a relation one-to-one, if you want to link a field to one control vocabulary, you can just remove this gateway, and you can connect it to a Cosmos instance directly without any change. And this is our idea, and we are now in the process of discussion with Harvard University and other partners how we are going to merge it to the master branch, and it will become available for all people. So another interesting example, and we are working on a few projects, and in this specific case, it's COVID-19 research project. And what we're trying to do, we actually converted a list of COVID-19 related questions into Cosmos. And basically, it's available in a Dataverse deposit form. So people that already have data, they can just query for questions. They can link those questions to data sets. And this is how it will go to linked open data cloud. So after this functionality will be merged to master branch, and all people from all depositors in Dataverse will get this possibility Probably data related to COVID-19 will be linked by them to the appropriate questions, and it can speed up the process of research and in this specific question about coronavirus outbreaks. And another thing, after they'll do it, because Dataverse has standardized protocols, so you can get data back and you can use it to train machine learning models. And it can also speed up any research things and projects. So thank you very much. And if you have questions, there are my contacts. Thanks.